गुड आफ्टरनून ब्रदर्स. नाउ टुडे लेट अस रीड. दिस इज क्वेश्चन फॉर 8th of January. ऑन 8th of January इन द एग्जाम यू हैव टू गो फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन. आई विल गिव यू दिस क्वेश्चन इन एग्जाम एंड यू नो यू हैव टू डू द फाइनल अकाउंट. दिस इज द ट्रायल बैलेंस. दिस इज क्वेश्चन ऑफ फाइनल अकाउंट. एज यू नो इट वेरी वेल, आई विल शो यू द क्वेश्चन, देन क्विकली आई विल स्टार्ट द आंसर. दिस इज क्वेश्चन in trial balance. Couple of ledger balances will be given both on debit as well as on credit side. On debit side you will be having expenditures, losses and assets will be given on debit side. Like I said in the class, in on the credit side of trial balance you will be having liabilities, incomes and some ledger balances may be gains. So from these given question we have to prepare final account, which consists of trading profit and loss account and balance sheet. You know, trial balance ends here and couple of adjustments are also given. I am showing you the question, then I will do the answer. So this is the question. Trial balance, debit side couple of items are there, credit side couple of items, and at the end couple of adjustments are given. By seeing this we have to prepare final account, which comprises of trading account, profit and loss account, and third stage is balance sheet. From the given question, some items should be taken in trading account, some should be taken in profit and loss account, some will appear in balance sheet. So in trading account, from the question, wherever you find goods in trial balance, wherever you find goods, that should be taken in a trading account. So trading account, main intention of preparing trading account is calculating gross profit. For that you have to take goods and expenditure related with goods. So in trading account, finally, once again I am telling you, goods will be taken, some on debit side, some on credit side, along with the direct expenditure and direct incomes will be taken. So in the question, first item is opening stock, and opening stock always appears on debit side of trading account, because this is goods and this goods is available in the business at the starting of the year and will be added to purchases. Therefore opening stock will be taken on debit side of trading account in every question, in every answer. Okay, and opening stock is 5000. Next item in question is purchases. Purchases are also goods. Wherever you find goods, I said you should be taken in trading account, and opening stock and purchases gets added. Therefore it should be taken on debit side of trading account. To purchases, always write its amount in inner column, because returns may be there that you have to deduct it. Therefore it should be written in the inner column. Purchases are also goods, therefore it appears in trading account. Next item is wages. Wages is an expenditure. So whenever you come across with expenditure, you have to decide, you have to make sure whether that expenditure is direct or indirect. You know, for that you have to see where it is happening and when it is happening. Wages happens in factory. Wages are remuneration which are given to the laborers who are connected with goods. So again, this expenditure is connected with goods. It is called as productive expenditure. It becomes direct. Therefore, it appears in trading account. Wages should be taken in trading account. And here you got adjustment. Therefore, put the amount of wages in inner column, and its amount is 800. Next item in the question is carriage. Carriage is just another name of transportation. Carriage is also expenditure. Decide whether it is direct or indirect. I said you in the question, it should be clear whether it is happening or while purchasing or while selling. Carriage should be given clearly as carriage on purchases or carriage on sales. But in this question, only carriage is given. So when only carriage is given, you have to assume, construed it as on purchases and should be taken in trading account. So carriage appears in trading account if it is on purchases. Purchases becomes direct, so this is direct expenditure. Take it to the outer column, no adjustment. Rent is given again in the question. Rent is indirect expenditure. Rent is indirect expenditure. If factory is not mentioned, only rent is given in the question, you have to assume that it is happening in office and should be considered as indirect expenditure. And rent also is having adjustment. Therefore, to adjust it, keep the amount in the inner column. After rent, there is salary. Salary always is direct, indirect expenditure, because salaries will be given to the employees who are working while selling goods. It is not attached with production, it is attached with selling and distribution. Therefore, salary, if factory is not mentioned, always it will be indirect expenditure. You don't have any adjustment, so put the amount straight away to the outer column. Next to salary is discount, and discounts in the question like this, it will be given both on debit side as well as on credit side. So discount, if it is on debit side, you have to assume it as allowed. Discount appearing on the credit side should be considered as received. So one become loss, another become income. So therefore, discount, if discount, debit side discount should be taken on debit side and assume it as allowed. Credit side discount, take it on credit side. Got it, sir? Credit side. Sometime will be given collectively, sometime only allowed will be there, only received will be there. Accordingly, you take it. So discount allowed amount is 400. Discount received amount is 2400. There is no adjustment. Next item is advertisement. Advertisement always is indirect expenditure, because advertisement will be done while selling the goods. Without any doubt, you can show it in the profit and loss account. Next item is custom duty. Custom duties, I said you, all types of duties will become direct expenditure. So take it in trading account. Next is factory insurance. Factory pay, factory name is given. So when factory name is given, it means you are insuring goods. So this expenditure is connected with goods, should be taken in trading account. No adjustment is there. Take the amount to the outer column. Okay. Next to that is machinery. Machinery is asset. It appears in balance sheet. Machinery got adjustment. Therefore, put the amount in the inner column and go ahead. Next item in trial balance is debtor. It is also assets. Debtors are group of individual from whom business is liable to receive money. Therefore, it becomes asset, should be taken on left hand side liability appears. Debtors also got adjustment. Put the amount in the inner column. Adjustment I will tell you afterwards. Next item is furniture. That is also asset. It appears on the same side in balance sheet. Furniture is also having adjustment. Put the amount in the inner column. Next is speed post charges. Speed post charges is indirect expenditure, postal expenditure which you are incurring while communicating with the outsider. From office you communicate, therefore it is indirect expenditure. No adjustment. Take the amount to the outer column. And lastly, last item in trial balance is bad debts. Bad debts, like I said you, sometime will be given inside the bad debts, sometime will be given inside the trial balance, sometime it will be given in adjustment. If it is given in adjustment, you take it twice. If it is given in trial balance, you take it only once. So bad debts, now it is given inside the trial balance, take it only once as a loss, and losses should be taken in profit and loss account, and this loss is not connected with goods, therefore it becomes indirect loss, should be taken in profit and loss account here. Okay, sir. And next is on the credit side. First credit side item is capital. Capital is liability. Liability, capital is liability, the amount what you are liable to the owner, it is liability, and you will pay it permanent. It is permanent capital. You will pay it back to the owner only at the time of liquidation. Till then, you have to show it every year as liability in balance sheet, capital. The next liability is creditor. Give some space, write creditors on the left hand side. Creditor is also amount which you are liable to pay to the outsider. It is liability. Take it, no adjustment. Take it on the left hand side. Then next followed by bills payable. That is also liability. I don't want to discuss regarding this. Same, it appears on liability side. Discount already we taken. Next item in the trial balance is sales. Sales means selling goods. Goods, whenever you come across with goods, should be taken in trading account. Therefore, take it in trading account, you don't have any return, so show the amount straight away to the outer column 9000. Then next item is overdraft. Overdraft is liability. Overdraft means it is liability to the bank. Show it on the left hand side in balance sheet. Overdraft amount is 2000. Now all items has been taken. After posting all the items from trial balance, go to adjustment, and all these adjustments should be taken twice. First item in trial balance is closing stock. Again it is goods. As it is goods, first it appears in a trading account on credit side. Why on credit side? Because from purchases closing stock will be deducted, so it should appear on credit side in trading account first time. Second time, goods which are left at the end of the year becomes asset, so show it as an asset. Second time, same amount, outer column 5400. Like this, every adjustment should be taken twice. Next adjustment is related with wages. You know, in adjustment wages, actually what you paid is 800. In adjustment, it is said that prepaid wages are 300. Prepaid means it will not be of this year, it will be of next year. And while preparing this year's, current year's final account, you cannot take any expenditures of next year. Therefore, it should be deducted from wages. And its amount is 300. Current year's wages will be 500. That show it in the outer column. Once you have deducted in trading account second time, as it is paid in advance, it appears as an asset. Prepaid, any prepaid expenditure will become asset second time. Show it as an asset, and its amount is 300. How much you added, that much you show it here. Next adjustment is outstanding rent. It is related with rent. Outstanding means due. It gets added. So once you add it to rent, if you add, it becomes 1400. Show it to the outer column. As this expenditure is outstanding, yet to be paid, second time it becomes liability. Outstanding rent. How much you added there? That much you show it, 400. I hope you understood. Next is depreciation. Depreciation is decrease in the value of assets. First it should be deducted from concerned asset. And depreciation is 5% on machinery. 5% depreciation on machinery will be 600. Deduct 600. Total amount of asset will be 11,400. Once you deducted here, second time depreciation should be shown as a loss. Depreciation on machinery as well as on furniture combinedly, collectively, let me show. Okay sir, machinery 600, furniture is 10%. This was 5%. Depreciation on furniture is 10%. 10% will be 900. This amount, net value of the furniture will be 8,100. Like this. Once you show it here, 1000 plus 600, it becomes 1600. You will show it as a loss. I have combined depreciation on machinery as well as on furniture. Okay, then next is RBD. So RBD is not there, data does not have any adjustment, take it as it is to the outer column. Now balancing, you have to balance it. First balance trading account, this is higher 14,400, this total is 14,400, and this total is something else, 14,400 higher amount, put it on both the side. This amount is 6,900. So from 14,400, if you deduct 6,900, gross profit whatever you get is 2,800. This you transfer it straight away to profit and loss account. I am not showing you the calculation, you do it on your own. I am running out of time. Therefore, gross profit, how to calculate? From credit amount, you have to deduct debit amount. If you deduct it, you will get this much. This transfer it to profit and loss account, and this total will be yeah, year expenditures are more, that is 6,800. Write it on both the side. 6,000 from 6,800. If you deduct this amount, you will get net loss. That loss is 1,600. Calculation, I am leaving it for you. You do it. And we have done this problem in the class. And now this loss again from here should be transferred to balance sheet. It should be deducted from capital. Net loss, if you deduct here, you will get 20,400. This amount, if you total now both liabilities and asset, it should be same. And it is getting, we are getting 31,200. Liabilities also 31,200. Assets also will be same, 31,200. Okay, sir. 11, 17, 17 plus this 8, 25, 30, 31,200. Okay, sir. 8, 9, 10. Okay, exactly we are getting same. Right. So, like this, you have to do the problem. I will show the question once again in the class. So, day after tomorrow, you do this in exam. Tomorrow, you study private and public limited company. Day after tomorrow, do this problem in exam. Okay, thank you.